Two different pandemic plot lines are playing out in Washington tonight. The president is defending his use of a drug that has not been approved for COVID-19, and Congress is focused on the relief money that it already approved and whether it should approve more. White House correspondent Yamiche Alcindor reports.
Washington remains under lockdown, but today President Trump was out and about. He visited the U.S. Capitol without wearing a mask to meet with Republican senators. He also defended taking daily doses of hydroxychloroquine. The drug has potentially dangerous side effects, and it is unproven against COVID-19.
Hello, everybody.
But President Trump dismissed warnings that his actions sent a dangerous message.
I think it gives you an additional level of safety, but you can ask many doctors who are in favor of it. Many frontline workers won't go there unless they have the hydroxy. And so, again, this is an individual decision to make.
Later at a cabinet meeting, he spoke again.
It doesn't seem to have any impact on me, but it seems to be a extra line of defense.
Meanwhile, Vice President Pence told Fox News he is not taking hydroxychloroquine. The president also announced he would sign an executive order directing government agencies to identify any regulations that can be temporarily waived to reopen the economy and promote growth. On an economic front, the Senate has begun negotiations on a new economic relief package. Though partisan divisions are squarely on display, Republican Senator Rick Scott of Florida.
If it's to help small businesses that don't have access to capital, I want to be helpful to them. But if it's to continue just to spend money without any accountability, I'm going to oppose it.
Minority Leader Chuck Schumer and other Democrats say the next bill must help workers as well as hard-hit states and local governments.
Are they for aid to state and local governments? Are they for so many of the things in the bill? More money for the hospitals, more help for testing, more money for PPE?
At a Senate hearing conducted via video conference, Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell pledged that a lending program for towns, cities, and states will be available by the end of the month. Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin argued for having businesses reopen under questioning by Pennsylvania Republican Pat Toomey.
The longer that we continue a shutdown, when weeks turn into months, doesn't that necessarily increase the risk?
There is the risk of permanent damage. And as I've said before, we're conscious of the health issues and we want to do this in a balanced and safe way.
But Ohio Democrat Sherrod Brown argued more should be done to protect workers.
The president says reopen slaughterhouses, nothing about slowing the line down, nothing about getting protective equipment. Is how many workers should give their lives to increase the GDP or the Dow Jones by 1,000 points?
You know, workers should give their lives to do that, Mr. Senator, and I think your characterization is unfair. We have provided enormous amounts of equipment.
Meanwhile, at another White House event today, President Trump threatened a permanent end to U.S. funding to the World Health Organization. It has already been suspended temporarily.
They have to be much more fair to other countries, including the United States, or we're not going to be involved with them anymore.
Late Monday, the president sent the WHO a letter accusing the group of letting China's influence deter efforts to prevent the pandemic. All the while, the virus continues its rampage. In Northwest India today, people stood in line waiting for COVID-19 tests as cases in the country reached 100,000. And Vietnam looked to jumpstart its economy by pushing for more domestic travel. The country has banned foreign visitors and its tourism industry has suffered greatly.
There are a few domestic tourists, but their spending on average is significantly lower than that of foreign tourists. The truth is, the situation is tough, really tough.
The story is much the same the world over, adding to pressure that grows daily to reopen. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Yamiche Alcindor.
The Congressional Budget Office today released the latest look at economic damage from the pandemic. It predicted the economy will contract this quarter at an annual rate of nearly 38%. The agency said it could take until 2021 to recover fully. Meanwhile, on Wall Street, the optimism that drove Monday's rally gave way to new doubts. The Dow Jones Industrial Average lost 390 points to close at 24,206. The NASDAQ fell 49 points, and the S&P 500 slipped 31.